We got some interesting news that came up this past week. We got contacted by one of the editors at PGI, and they wanted to do a two-page article on unknown soldiers. So as a joke to the guys, I didn't tell any of them, and I just posted on our message forum saying, hey, make sure you come to the field all washed up, you know, ready to go.
And what we're doing today is we're doing a photo shoot for the magazine. We have an article in PGI magazine.
Wow. Yeah.
So that's pretty
right.
How you doing?
The ambient temperature. We're striking a deal with our very first licensing deal. So that's going to be with Leaf and Custom Made KM with the straps. We're all underdogs trying to do something that's, you know, obviously not the easiest thing to do, as we know. But people are seeing that and being inspired. The number one thing I did when I started the with the Unknown Soldiers concept, what I wanted was what we're doing to inspire others to want to do what we're doing and grow the sport, and that's absolutely working. Every time that word comes up, you guys inspired me, you guys are inspiration, that's how I check into seeing if we're doing our job or not. And we're getting a lot of that.
You know, there's a difference. You know, we can be a trinket, you know, a novelty, where, oh yeah, these guys are just videotaping everything, and we can stay in 22nd, 23rd, 20th place, or we can be a gem, you know, where we make this work for us. I want to make this work for us. You know, first step, Sunday. Sunday is our first step. And then after, you know, screw that, you know, we don't want to be a mediocre team. We want to be the team that everybody's saying, hey, those are the unknown soldiers. Okay, so let's stretch it out. Let's do our running, and we'll start on our drills. Let's get it going. You guys cool with this?
Perfect.
Yeah, buddy.
Unknown soldiers, baby.
Jason, I just keep this or I want to see.
What else, motherfucking DS?
Transcend Paintball, Maddie Marshall's new website that is going to talk about paintball and paintball-related stories. Check it out.
Of the world, Maddie!
Of the world?
Unfortunately, due to personal circumstances, this was Scott's last practice with the team. Another one bites the dust. And that's the name of the game. And we're parting in such sweet sorrow.
World, Craig!
Buenos dias.
What y'all doing?
Looking cam.
Scott, you made it back out, huh?
Sir?
Right after Huntington Beach, Josh Marine was deployed with the Navy. This was his first practice back with the team since his deployment.
How you doing? Good, man.
Jousting drill number one is basically a running and gunning drill. You start at opposite ends of the field and run to the center of the field, shooting at each other. Once you get to the center, you stop. It's basically just keeping your aim at a moving target while running yourself.
One, go!
It's a joust, this is the real jousting drill, okay?
Yeah.
So you're trying to shoot back at the guy, you're gonna be running to 301. And then when you get to Jadrita 1, regardless of whether or not you got hit, then try to assert dominance down the tape and win that gunfight, okay?
On the tape?
Yeah, on the tape.
Go!
Scott, you win. Good job.
Whoa!
The 5-on-3 drill is basically an aggression and a defensive drill. The 5 are going as fast as they can to close out the game, and the 3 are doing everything they can to defend.
And then for the 5, I want a guy at the notch, a snake 1, so all the way at the back of the snake, the car wash, Dorito 1, back left, so 1, 2, Aztec, so 1, 2, 3, four, and then back right. And you have 3 minutes.
Go!
After practice, Maddie laid down the law.
I mean, come on now. Guys, that's bullshit. Fucking rookie-ass excuses.
Dude. Yeah.
Yeah. Rookie-ass excuses. Own your shit. You guys saw the fucking movie. Own your shit. If you don't own your shit, we're never going to get any better. You're going to take fucking 24th and 20th all year long, and everyone's going to know you guys suck. Is that what you want fucking people to know about?
Fuck no.
No. All right. Well, take this shit fucking... Is this shit personal? You spent a lot of money and time doing this, right? Okay, well, you're not out here, it's not just all fun, right? I mean, this it does mean some of you guys that you win and get better, right? Okay, well, fucking, then own your shit. No more fucking excuses, dude. We come off and you fucked up, I wanna hear I fucked up. Not, oh, this happened and fucking God, the stars aligned and Armageddon happened and the angels came down and shot me. Okay, that's not what I wanna hear.
You should burn it.
No.
We only got two guys.
Get over it.
On the glossary, it says the great unknown. It goes a Division III team in PGI's pro laden pages. That'll be the day. Well, it seems that the calendar's fast. Check out San Diego's hottest YouTube paintballers, the Unknown Soldiers.
Contrary to many people's belief, we do not have a free ride. We struggle just like other teams to pay for these events. Yes, we do have some sponsorships, but like we all know, this sport is not cheap.
We gotta, you know, even if it's chipping away, you know, $10 at a time, we gotta try to get those things down just so that we can play these next events. You know, as of right now, you know, we don't have event number four paid for. We have two more events. G. Scott Asphalt is not going to be paying any more money into the team. You know, G. Scott Asphalt's put about 10 grand so far into the team. So they're not, they're tapped on the sponsorship side.
The last event, everything was taken care of before. You know, this event's, the plane tickets are a little more expensive, but we don't have the hotel rooms paid for. So if we can start trying to chip away at the money that's owed, you know, so that we gotta get the money thing taken care of. Cam, he just told us that he's done for now. He can't afford to play paintball anymore. Real close to the event, a little tough. You guys have all, you know, I'm sure you talked to each one of you guys about it, right?
When we started this whole thing, dude, is everybody understood that if you couldn't make the financial commitment and keep up with what was going on, then, you know, you should have been stepped aside. And I just totally bypassed that, you know, like I said, it was selfish of me, you know, to continue on, you know, while everybody else, you know, that can take care of the shit, you know, take care of the shit and still got me over here that doesn't take care of shit. So.
I mean, I think the bottom line, though, number one out of everything, though, is would you want to play at Boston?
Dude, I don't think that question has to be answered by anybody.
Do you want to play at Boston? Seriously?
Yeah.
Okay, then you're going to play Boston.
It's only 2 weeks away. And, you know, with you being there, that solves everything as far as with this team. We don't have to go. We don't want to go outside of us. I mean, I don't think anybody wants to pull just any old person and just jump, put them on this team. You earn... I mean, you sacrifice like how everyone else is sacrificing all of our own ways. You know, you sacrifice to get here to get to Boston, and for you to not, you know, to come three feet from gold basically and cut yourself short is not, you know, is not. I don't think what any of us want to do. And the way that I feel about it is, let's solve everything after Boston if we need to. You know what I mean?
Okay, guys, let's say, as an example, whatever we decide, right? Let's say it was fucking car washes or whatever. It doesn't matter what it is. Let's say whatever we decided. Right now, we know Cam's in this particular situation. Boston's coming up.
Yep.
If we ended up doing car washes, when we ended up making $5,000 in car washes, are we okay as a team paying back Josh, if that's what we ended up wanting to do, out of that $5,000 we all make to pay back Cam's ticket? Everyone cool with that?
Yeah. To get I mean, Josh? Regardless of
fundraising.
Yeah, regardless of where it goes, it's the team. We're all in it together. I mean, we're all doing it for a purpose to help each other out. I mean, that's, I mean,
yeah,
hopefully.
That's the bottom line. So
yeah,
the
I mean.
Bottom line is helping each other out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
None of us should be in this to make money. So if we end up making money somehow, like fundraiser type shit, whatever, it should go back to the team.
Yeah.
Cam's part of the team. If it goes back to pay his part of the ticket, I'm fine with that.
Yeah.
Everybody should
yeah.
be fine with that. Because none of us should be expecting to make money at all on this. The only money we should be expecting to make is if we use
yeah.
to play paintball, or we win an event and make money, but that money should go back to the team.
Yeah,
right. But more importantly is to focus on Boston. Let's get to Boston. Everyone is almost there, right? Let's get Boston. Let's do the best that we can. And then from there, really sit down and go, okay, how do we take care of ourselves? You know, how do we take care of ourselves as players so that we're not stressed out every month? Because right now it feels like, I think, you know, Ed, you were talking about that.
Yeah.
Cam, for sure. Jason's got his stuff going on. Everybody, I have my own version of it, trust me. So it's like, and Mike and his commitments, his family, everything. Everyone pays a price, right? So let's figure out how to make that price either pay for itself or like in a way that we can leverage whatever we're doing so we're not paying as a higher price. And not basically take the pain out of the equation.
Next stop, my hometown, Boston.
Scott Tolson, gone, but not forgotten.